Yeah, so I have so many tabs open on my phone that I'm gonna use this time to clear it out. Or to jot down any notes. Anything I want to. Sorry about that. Okay, that's enough for today.
Two rose bushes in a florist shop. One person comes in, buys one of the rose bushes, brings it home, waters it just the amount it's meant to be watered, gives it just the perfect amount of sun, puts it exactly where it needs to be, and that plant grows to be beautiful. Grows to be perfect. If that plant could sing, it would sing a song. Someone comes in and buys the other rose bush, brings it home, waters it too much, gives it too much sun, gives it not enough of what it needs, and that rose bush has a completely different outcome because of it. Now, the one rose bush could look at the other rose bush and be like, wow, that rose bush is so beautiful over there across the street. There must be something wrong with me. When in fact, there's nothing wrong with it. It's just an environment was not set up to properly grow it. We could probably agree that both those two rose bushes in the florist shop are both inherently worthy. One was not more worthy than the other. However, with the environments of growing up, they may make different internalizations about who they are and what they're worthy of based on that. This is, of course, a metaphor. But the idea is that in the same way, when it comes to worthiness with all of us, no one is more worthy than anyone else. It's just that the conditions growing up may have been that that was what was internalized. So a very powerful thing to do is to realize that now that yourself in the right environment and let go of the belief of the shame, the guilt, whatever energies are there that are keeping you from expressing who you really are. So, in essence, there's nothing wrong with you.
Hello, are you listening?
Yeah, those are... Oh my gosh. Yeah, those are in Doughty. It's just some good stuff. Sometimes he hits it really, hits the nail on the mark, the head.